Let's use the Roto Brush 3 with the help of Generative Fill to transform our background. And I'll show you a few tips and tricks along the way. Let's dive into it. Okay, I have my clip here, and I'm gonna take a screenshot to help generate my background. So I'll go to Composition, Save Frame As, File, and I'll open that rendered PSD in Photoshop. All right, now I'm in Photoshop with my screenshot, and I'll click Select Subject, and I'll click on Select Inverse, and delete the background. So real quick, before we get any further, I'm excited to share a super powerful tool that can supercharge your creativity in Photoshop. It's called ImageCreator. This free AI plugin unleashes the power of stable diffusion and similar models, allowing you to generate stunning artwork from text descriptions with ease using text to image, save tons of time by intelligently filling in areas with the fill feature. Within the Image Creator plugin, users can access thousands of AI models on Model Hub, meeting the needs for creative expressions in any style. So get that creativity going and download Image Creator for free. The link is below in the description. All right, let's dive into Photoshop. Now, I'll use Generative Fill and I'll type in my prompt to generate an Urban Explorer setting. After a few prompt adjustments, here's what I got. Now I'm just gonna clean my scene up. I'm gonna select my subject and just do an empty prompt to generate, and that should remove her. And I'll clean it up a little bit more. Now I'll go to Layer, Merge Visible. And jumping back to After Effects, I'm gonna start rotoscoping my subject. I'll double click my source clip and select my Roto Brush or hit Option W. And using the green brush, I'll select my subject. To change my brush size, all I have to do is hold Command and mouse up or down. Just hold Option and the brush will turn red and it'll remove that specific part. So now we'll just clean up some of the details. I'll switch over to my Refine Edge tool by hitting Option W again, and it'll turn almost a purple. And now I'll just outline my subject here to give some flexibility with my edge to work with if I need it. Once I'm good with that, I can change my view on the bottom panel to see my roto. Okay, that actually looks pretty good. So if I want to adjust my settings here, I could. And because I outlined the subject's edge, I can adjust these settings. I can adjust shadow reduction, smoothing, feathering, etc. And a quick rotoscoping tip, once I have my roto looking good like this, and I wanna proceed with more work in the comp, I can pre-render my roto layer and speed up my computer. So with my roto layer selected, I'll go to Composition, Pre-render, and I'll make sure it's exporting with Alpha Channel. Render and bring that into your comp, replacing your Roto Brush video layer. And let's actually keep our Roto Brush source layer. We'll hide this because we'll need this for tracking. So now I'll grab my new background I made earlier, the PSD, and I'll drag that into my comp. With my original video layer selected, I'll go to Animation, Track in Boris FX Mocha. Click on the Mocha icon and Mocha will pop up, and we can grab our X-Spline tool. I'm gonna grab a few points on my background with a good amount of detail and contrast. Now I'll hit Show Surface and hit Align Surface so my tracked layer keeps the proportions of the comp. Now I'll track forward and I'll speed this up for you. And once that's done, I'll hit Save and I'll close out Mocha, jump back to After Effects, drop down my tracking data, and hit Create Track Data. Hit OK. And in Layer Export 2, I'll select my background. And hit Apply Export. And this is going to apply all the data to that background layer. That looks really good. And one last finishing touch that I did was I added an adjustment layer with a camera lens blur and animated the mask to go along with my subject. This mimics the focus adjustment of my source clip and just sells the effect that much more. Here's the final result.